Good morning and welcome to St. Luke's. We're glad that you are worshiping with us this morning. Hear this call to worship. The Lord is our refuge. We can find peace in God's abiding love. When troubles assail us, we call upon the Lord. When joy abounds, we call upon the Lord. Welcome this day to God's house, one of many dwellings of the Almighty One. We thank you and praise you, God, for his refuge and sanctuary. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, on this day of the festival of the Christian home, the celebration of Mother's Day, the witness to the eternal love of Christ, remind us that we are responsible for caring for each other. We are called to lift up rather than to tear down, to support rather than abandon, to reach out when others have turned away. Give us hearts of love that in all places and times we may be witnesses to the hope that is found in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Good morning. Our opening hymn this morning is The Care the Eagle Gives Her Young, number 118 in the hymnal.
Sometimes if your birthday's coming or you're going to do something really special this weekend and your mom and your dad or your mom and your dad have said we're going to do this, but you're like, well, how long is that going to be? And so you wait. Or sometimes you might wait and be worried about something like we're going to drive from here to there and we just want to be safe, and so you think, should I wait? How am I going to wait for this? And then you get in the car and you think, are we safe? And just things like that sometimes that we worry about, that, you know, we just need to take our time and we need to wait and we need to watch, because God is going to do some amazing things in that time. But this morning what we're going to do is I'm going to put my timer on and I'm going to show you guys a minute. We're going to take a minute and we're going to see what it's like to just wait. So here we go. So waiting sometimes is easy, sometimes hard. I want to look at what I'm doing and I think about, oh, we got so 47 seconds and gosh, look at my other watch, look at the ceiling, look at things, and I'm thinking, oh, we got 38 seconds to go. I wish time would hurry up and finish. 32 seconds. Oh, you know, after this, I think I'm going to go get some ice cream. You know, ice cream would be really good, but our can't do it right now because I'm waiting with you guys, and it's, let's see, it's 18 seconds, 16 seconds, let's see. I just love waiting, don't you love waiting? 10 seconds, we're counting down, okay. Look away, we'll look away, don't look at the timer, let's see what its time is up. Okay, it's up, time's up. And you know, sometimes when we're like that, a minute in long, but a minute can seem like so long, especially when we're waiting for something that we really want to have happen. In the book of John, in the Bible, Jesus talks about that. He talks about what it's like to wait. And he says, don't be worried and upset, Jesus told them. Believe in God, also believe in me. And he said something about time right after that. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And he's talking about heaven. I go to make sure that you know that there's a place for you to be. But also I'm coming back. So not just going away, but I'm coming back. And we don't know what that time is. But we do know that in the middle of that, what we're supposed to be doing is caring for each other, loving each other, spending time together. So today, what I want you to do is to think about what can you do to spend time with someone very special in your life. Thank you, guys. Have a great day.
Hi, I'm Denig, and I love my mom because she always gives me kisses, and she plays with me when I want her to play with me. Plus, she also loves me, and I also love her too.
I want to wish my mom, Rebecca McLeod, a happy Mother's Day. Sorry that we can't be there, I can't be there, but just want you to know that I love you dearly. Thank you for all that you have done, all that you're doing now with the crisis going on. I wish I could be there. I love you and hope you have a tremendous special day this Sunday on Mother's Day. Thank you.
We want to wish our mom and Nana Grammy a very happy Mother's Day.
Remembering my mother, Eve Byer, today. She was a wonderful, warm person at times and truly showed me how a mother should love a child. And I'm very fortunate to have had that model as I've moved into motherhood myself. So she also was a true believer and had a very deep faith in God and in His love for each of us. So I'm wonderfully appreciative and thankful and grateful for the mother that I had.
Good morning and happy Mother's Day. I lost my mom to cancer when she was only 57. So in a sense, all the mothers and all the women in the church are mothers to me. So blessings and thank you on this special day.
Our scripture this morning is taken from the Gospel of John, the 14th chapter, and I'll be reading the first three verses of that chapter. Hear now the word of the Lord. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. My friends, these are the words of God for us, the people of God. Together may we say, thanks be to God. Amen. Do not let your hearts be troubled. It's difficult to read these words without thinking about all that is happening in our world today. From the pandemic called COVID-19, to the sickness and death, to the unemployment, to the social distancing, to closings of businesses and lack of income, and for our brothers and sisters who live on the margins, having a much more difficult time to make ends meet. And maybe hearing these words, our difficulties might be even more than just those things. Maybe we've experienced a recent diagnosis, or maybe we're in the midst of a parenting crisis. Or maybe we're struggling with marriage problems. Or maybe there are other things happening in our life that are even too difficult to articulate. Do not let your hearts be troubled. At some point in our lives, we've heard these words read. Maybe it was at a funeral. Maybe it was in a worship service. Maybe it was with a friend. But do we really understand what these words are saying to us? What do we make of these words as we go through this day as we deal with all that is taking place in our world. Biblically, we could say we know these are words spoken by Jesus to his disciples following that meal where Jesus washed his disciples' feet and then he broke bread with them there in the upper room. It was a farewell meal with his disciples. Theologically, we know that a portion of John's gospel that begins with the 14th chapter is Jesus sharing a farewell discourse with his disciples, preparing them for the future when he is no longer with them. He's offering them guidance in how to live their lives following Jesus' death and resurrection. Although these words spoken to the disciples prior to his crucifixion, these words spoken to them, and yet they had difficulty understanding them. In the 16th chapter of John, we hear these words, "I have said these things to keep you from stumbling." And yet, like the disciples who struggled with understanding these words, we too stumble. We have our moments of anxiousness, and we even allow anxiety to grow within us when trouble comes. So let's be honest this morning. How many times have we awakened in the middle of the night with our heart racing, our palms sweating, and we're struggling with an issue, a problem, a concern, or a need? I'll be the first to admit that my name should be on the top of that list. I'm a fixer. And for a lot of us, we are fixers. And we want to resolve problems. We want to take care of things. We want to make life better for someone or something when it comes our way. But wait. What happens when we can't fix those things? What happens when we can't resolve those problems? What happens when that concern comes our way and we're not able to resolve it? What do we make of these words that Jesus spoke to his disciples? Do not let your hearts be troubled. Are we saying that we don't believe in these words? Are we saying that we have no trust in what God can do? Or are we saying that we believe that God's love is fleeting and only possible for a certain time or a certain place? Are we saying that the mercy of God has restrictions or requirements or hoops we have to jump through before things can be resolved or problems solved or concerns addressed? Are we saying when we've got to do it that we're unwilling or we believe that God has limits on what God can do? It's a struggle. And yet, where is God in the midst of that struggle that you and I have as we journey through life? Before my 18th birthday, I went through three surgeries. None of them were major. They were simple things, a broken arm, some tonsils that needed to be removed, and a cyst that needed to be removed. Today they'd all be outpatient, but back long ago, each required a hospitalization. Amazingly, the simplest of those three surgeries was the most difficult for me to heal from. As a junior in high school, I was embarrassed that I had to have a cyst removed. This cyst did not allow me to participate in any athletic activities as a junior. I had to wait for the surgery, had the surgery, and then I had to recover from the surgery. It was embarrassing, it was frustrating, and as a 17-year-old guy, I didn't want to talk about it to anybody. All I wanted was life to get back to normal, like it was the year before. Although I never did admit to my family or to my friends much about what was going on, I didn't share with them my anger, I didn't share with them my upset feelings, I didn't share with them the feeling I felt in my heart. What happens if this doesn't heal? But it was there, and I was struggling with it. So one night at church youth group, I confided in one of our adult counselors. They heard me tell my story, and then their response was simple but meaningful to me. They said, "Let go and let God handle this." Today, some 40 years later, they probably don't remember ever saying that. But for me, they were life-giving words. Their words were synonymous to the words that we read later in that chapter, verse 27 of the 14th chapter of John. "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid." I experienced in that moment peace. Let go and let God take care of it. Today is Mother's Day, a day to honor mothers, and you can read about the beginnings of Mother's Day through the story of Anna Jarvis and the Little Methodist Church in Grafton, West Virginia. A day to celebrate and to give thanks. And we United Methodists also call this day the day of the festival of the Christian home. A day to celebrate parents and those who are raising children. A day to celebrate those who are caring for the little ones. It is my belief that as parents, as mothers and fathers and aunts and grandmothers and foster parents, that we have a wonderful opportunity to share faith with our children, to share with them the gift of God's creation, to share with them the gift of Jesus, our Redeemer, to share with them the gift of the Holy Spirit. And in sharing with them these precious gifts, we offer them the opportunity to meet and to hear about a Lord that loves them and cares for them and will be with them no matter what the future holds. Isn't that why we're here? Isn't that why we worship? Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me, Jesus says. May we have belief, for there is hope, not only for today, but also for tomorrow and for the future. Believe. 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 In the name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Sound of his voice.
We go to the Lord in prayer this morning, inviting you once again to send your prayer request in or type it in the message below, comment line below in Facebook or social media. So this morning, we lift up those that are caring for one another. We lift up our doctors and our nurses. And we continue to lift up our government officials and our state governor and all those that are having to make some really hard decisions. And most of all, we lift up the body of Christ. Wherever you are and whatever you're going through right now, we are praying for you this morning. So let us all bow our heads and go to the Lord in prayer. Most gracious and loving God, we come before you once again, calling on your name, knowing that you hear us. But God, leaning on your truth, leaning on your understanding, seeking to hear your word, seeking to hear your voice. And God, we are so thankful that we can call on your name, that you hear us. Help us to be present with you, Lord, in the midst of life and changes. Sometimes our routines get out of whack, and we need a reminder to call on you. Help us to be mindful that this should be a part of our routine daily, not just when we want something or when something occurs. And so this morning, Lord, we draw into your presence. We draw understanding that we don't have all the answers, but yet you do. That we need to sit at your feet and discern. Sit at your feet and learn. Sit at your feet and gain as much wisdom so that we can live life to the fullest as you have called us to. So Lord, we sit at your feet this morning and we lift up our friends to you. Those that are sick, Lord, with allergies and having surgery, routine surgeries, Lord, we lift them up to you today. Lord, we lift up those in the hospital who are under medical care for various reasons. Lord, we offer prayer for them, asking for your healing, but also asking for your tender touch. Lord, we pray for those in the nursing homes and those nurses and doctors that are caring for them. All of our medical staff across the world, Lord, we lift up them today. Lord, we pray for those living on the margins and those in the midst of conflict in their homes. Gosh, there is so much going on around us that maybe our eyes are not seeing, but our hearts are feeling. And so, God, we lift up our friends and our neighbors. We don't know what's happening in their world, but, God, we just pray for peace amongst all your people. And, God, we just pray most of all for your church. Lord, where we're sitting in isolation, you are doing remarkable things through online worship, through virtual and technology communication, whether it's Zoom or FaceTime or Google. Oh God, you are using all these resources to bring good and fruitfulness in your name. And God, where we have doubted, Lord, let this be a sign for us that you are still in charge. You are still sitting on the throne. You are walking us through and navigating us through a new life, a new way of living, a new way of doing ministry. So God, where we are anxious about that or maybe scared, Lord, let our hearts not be troubled about it, but trust in you Help us to be faithful in all that we do, showing up and having our conversation and prayer with you, but also reaching out and loving others in the best way we can right now. God, it is through our actions that we can demonstrate your love in a world that so desperately needs it. And so, God, we pray for you to show us new ways to do that. And God, we just thank you again for all that you do and all that you are and the wonderful ways that you are revealing your beautiful love in this broken world. God, help us to be mindful. Help us to cling to your word. Help us to always seek your wisdom. And Lord, most of all, let us not be troubled or worried, but be reminded that you, O God, are right there with us. And God, it just as Jesus and the disciples prayed, we also pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning, St. Luke's. This is Andrew Straw from your Staff Parish Relations Committee, and I'm back again with you this week to share with you the news that the conference has reappointed Associate Pastors Monica Childers and Raimundo Villanueva to serve St. Luke's for another year. So join me in congratulating them, wishing them God's blessings, and pledging our support as they continue their ministries in the challenging pandemic environment.
And now as we go from our places of worship, be it at our home or out on the picnic table or on the porch or wherever we may be this day, as we go from this place of worship back into the world, may we carry with us a deep and abiding belief of God's amazing love, and that God will be with us, and that God's mercy and grace will guide us, and that there is hope. In the name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen.
This is our closing hymn today on Eagle's Wings, number 143 in the hymnal. We will sing this through twice.